Our years of instability in Libya and limited funding have affected the media sector, forcing many local newspapers to shut down or limit their operations to online publication. A few remaining print newspapers are largely unable to publish print versions, as years of instability have taken a toll on the industry, forcing hundreds of newspapers out of business.
Newspapers have been unable to restart production since 2014, due mainly to a lack of funding and resources. Libya has been hit by difficulties in its economic, political and security affairs in the years following the popular uprising which deposed former leader Gaddafi and ended four decades of a one-man rule. As a result, close to 600 local private and state-owned newspapers were forced to shut down, and only 15 of the newspapers that are still running can afford to print sporadic copies.
Sharp polarization also impacted the media scene in Libya and has created journalists who are unable to express their opinions freely or with credibility, because this polarization has made them either journalists who will follow and represent just one side or journalists who stay silent. Out of this stemmed a reluctance among journalists and media personalities to continue in this profession.
While a newspaper is sold for just half a Libyan dinar, the cost of printing a single copy can reach 5 Libyan dinars. Some newspapers have moved offices to neighboring Tunisia. The English-language privately owned Libya Herald now operates out of the capital, publishing its daily digest only on the internet.
The main problem, in my view, is that of funding and the stopping of printing press, as well as the economic situation or economic recession that happened in the country. It is purely an economic problem, but also there is the stoppage of printing, the unavailability of paper to print on, and the lack of means available to restart these printing presses again, which belong to the state and are still closed until this very moment. This is because government negligence.
Since 2014, Libya's main printing press has shut down. The printing press capacity used to produce 45,000 copies a year. Its machines have turned yellow from accumulated dust, and the last newspaper copy is still jammed inside the machine with faded ink.
The main problem, in my view, is that of funding and the stopping of printing press, as well as the economic situation or economic recession that happened in the country. It is purely an economic problem, but also there is the stoppage of printing, the unavailability of paper to print on, and the lack of means available to restart these printing presses again.
Libya descended into chaos after the overthrow and killing of Gaddafi, with two competing governments backed by militias scrambling for control of the oil-producing country.
And finally, Telkom Kenya and Bharti Airtel's local units plan to merge some operations as a first step, as Telkom plans to acquire all of Airtel's Kenya assets. Telkom Kenya plans to take over all of Airtel Kenya eventually, but it has yet to decide on a structure. And that's a wrap on the program for today. Thank you very much for watching. I'm Chimezie Obi Wabu.